All right, now let's do this and get you on to the next chapter. Apparently, it's called Barnes' Gambit, which should be interesting. Apparently, we followed her suggestion and we're heading straight there. We apparently don't see the brothers. So we go full bow and now we fight Captain Barnes, basically. This game really likes big maps. I like this Diane person. Dang. The Renaissance, man, it's not only something bad. Alright. Is that the potential ally right there? All right there. And of course, right when he says that, we get bombarded. So we're retaking a fort, basically. Ooh, we get a... no fortune, though. So we got Jesus with us. Guess it was a good thing I got an iron lance and... an extra hand axe from Felipe. And he comes with a steel sword, a steel axe, that's good. I'll give her an extra heal while I'll give him an extra shine. And please say everybody's decent. Because that'll be his same decent chapter, so you just gotta go through it. Gonna have to deploy her. So far, wait, there's droppable physic. Droppable speed wing. That's all. Alright, so since there's not much to do, we just gotta continue on. Timoteo himself has a longbow, which is getting an S rank. That's pretty good right there, you can go through those. But our magic users are probably gonna be our best bet since they have... normally these enemies have low resistance, or in this case pretty decent resistance for that promoted enemy. Alright, so they're all actually starting to move, which shows this guy probably learned, or perhaps the first level is done like that on purpose? Ah well. Fight Timoteo! I like the bright color scheme on Miguel. Nice. Luckily, since he's an armor lord, that shouldn't really do any damage. Nah, that's it. Actually, yeah, let's do it. Might as well start leveling up our everybody, right? Oh, a longbow. Nice, I missed. Oh! And I expect the random critical. So now he's gotta move around. Looks like there's a chest, but I have no way that can open it. Glad Nathan bought back him up. And as we keep on going, we just keep on making sure everybody catches up. Ooh, the female one. Female sword masters look nice and they hurt. So the better idea would be trying to take them out as quickly as possible. I'll let them attack him right there. Dang, it missed. Finally, that one hit at the least. Come on, Nathan! Yeah, almost as good as the real Nathan. He's so unthankful Claudio holds a sword. Okay, that takes care of those sword masters, so we still can't go on them. We'll kill them off with this. Good, he's off the plant. Not the plant, he's off the forest, which is good. That'll make him easy to kill next. Dang, that missed. At least that hit. Huh? Okay, he's our man, yeah. He's an idiot. Thank you. Unfortunately, they're not playable, looks like. He's in the frame, Lord. He's got pretty decent stats, though. And S-Rank and Spears. She's just a basic druid, and Caleb's a basic lord, so I'm probably not going to be using him. Meanwhile, I got an assassin. Ooh, those that skill and speed are pretty good. At least decent damage. That one has such speed. I should have bought another iron sword because I didn't know about Nathan joining. It would have been better to have an iron sword instead of a silver sword to save up time. Or, well, to save up ammunition. Alright, level up Laura. Oh yeah, I forgot about Felipe attacking. Dang it. Ooh, I like his sprite. Ouch. Okay, after this we can start rendezvousing and doing stuff. After we kill this enemy right here. Lore and steel swords just go so well together, it looks like. Oh, they do go well together. Oh, to Mateo. Dang. I'm definitely getting lucky this time. All right, secret book. Oh, he died for it. That way you can get closer right there to, oh yeah, to Claudio. Yeah, yeah, bros. And of course, he convinces Dylan. That, he's a jerk. At least Mr. Renaissance understands me. Oh, sweet, she has a staff. I need to start healing like crazy. I was about to say something about the sprite, but it would make sense. I don't think they really had a female druid sprite in FE7. And the guy's using specifically what's in the game. Okay, everybody so far seems decently healed or has decent stuff. So we'll use Nate, we'll have to get Laura healed next. Then we'll use Nate to visit that next village and we should be good. Okay, so we got a kind looking guy. He's speaking smarter than they do already. Well, that's a recruitable character I haven't seen one myself. Wow. And it's like I save, rescue him, get him over to here to get whatever's in there. Alright, so that's the plan for now, it's just to kill him. Okay, I'm turning off that animation, it's taking too long. That'll work. And now that we're through with that, let's get on moving straight. That's a treat for now. So I want that bandit. I just don't know who he belongs to. Alright, now that that's good. Dang, really? She's not even fast enough for that? Let's run back some more. Yeah, I am so kind to myself right now. Let's see some more info about him. His name's Benedict. He's got decent stats for level 1 Berserker. Downside is the stat, this doesn't have that growth patch. Let's unlock this. Brave bow, nice. We're probably taking those guys down next turn then. Ouch. Dang! Got him. He's got no... Dang, he does not like himself. And he's using honorifics. That was a quick way to join. Nice. Let's hear our boy Timoteo. Nice. Now let's get back into this fight. First gotta heal people though. they'll start stealing more and just keep on going straight through there. Kinda happy I didn't have to overextend though, it was one of the things I was happy about. He had courage for sure if his first ever hit was a critical. Now he's actually moving in instead. $5,000 gold, just what we need. Now he's gotta move everybody straight, basically. I'm dropping Silvaro for sure. I guess this part of the stage was to show that Benedict was worth recruiting. Nice eclipse. Felipe basically owns this map. Now they're finally actually making some progress, so getting through this. We're just gonna have to use him to track them. Since I know, knowing this guy, he's probably got enough. He's got enough avoid for it. I hope. Because basically, I'm banking it on that. Ouch. I got lucky. Yeah, we need to heal. on, she looks cute. Cute enough to die. Nice. Alright, as we keep on going, we're basically about to end it. Wait. Nice. And of course, the usual reinforcements. Yes, death. Come on, let's go for critical. Come on, critical. Ah, no critical. No, we're gonna have to do it. The painfulness of a hand axe. I'm guessing they went for like a self-preservation mode or something. Cause it didn't attack. If it didn't attack with the sword, I would have been in trouble. Oh, you never know with AI's own style of doing things. Oops. I took the wrong person. Alright, now we can finish this. Alright, he's got Delphi shield. That works. It's painful, but it works. It's gonna hurt, but it at least works. Alright, let's finish it off with Claudio himself. Dang, always a death threat, Claudio. Oh, his portrait changed. He's got markings. Nice, finally some strength. Alright, we got a seize. Alright, so now... guess the battle was won, but the war isn't. I like his little brother, he's nice. And then she's being the realistic one. Considering that Claudio's not promoted and he doesn't have a special weapon to himself other than a rapier, I'm probably not using Claudio. Not Claudio, probably not using Caleb. Or whatever his name is. I suck with names. He has a good idea in trying to charge the enemy, but they don't have enough forces. She's got a point, Massalon. He used wrecked in the weirdest way. Smart. She's not wrong. She's such a kind lady. Very respectful, I like that about her. Yeah. That was smart. He has respect that. I could tell if this were Ashnard or something, he would have instantly killed that person. But it wasn't. Estar, he looks familiar. That's bright. I think from Fire Emblem 12? I'll figure it out on the next part. Alright then, I'm getting back into it, but, you know, it's just life. Regardless, thank you all for watching. Till the next part, goodbye.